In this lesson, we will configure high availability. We need to configure high availability to back up our devices. In case of a malfunction of one of our devices, we need to do this so that our other device will be activated automatically. We have already set up our device here. I made self IP addresses, IP version 6 addresses and IP version 6 default route settings on our second device. You need to configure these IP addresses beforehand, because the IP addresses on this device do not go to the device here during synchronization, because the IP addresses of the devices need to be different. After configuring high availability, we will send the configuration on our first device to our second device in the same way. This device will wait in standby, and because the floating IP is the same on both devices, our device will be active when this device goes from active to standby state, and when it is active, the floating IP will be active. Since we have set 172.16.0.222 as the gateway address on the user's side, if this device is disabled, we will ensure that the traffic flow continues without making any changes on the user's side, since the IP address of this device is the same. We will use 10.1.0.2 as the high availability IP address for our second device. We will also use 10.1.0.1 on our first device. Let's go to the LTM side and start our configuration. Now I came to our first device, let's check the IP addresses of our second device first, then let's start our configuration. Now I come to our second device Big IP 2. Let's come to self IP from the network tab here. When we come here, you can see the IP addresses. I set the internal address as 172.16.0.102 and the external address as 192.168.10.102. I also made the IP version 6 floating IP address 222. I also made the IP version 6 self external address 102. Our floating IP addresses here are the same on both devices. The IP of our first device is 101, the IP of our second device is 102. Likewise, the internal self IP of our first device is 101, and our second device is 102. Here we will give the floating IPs of our external and internal interface the same as our first device. We also have an IP version 6 default route. Don't forget to write this IP version 6 default route as well. After configuring these IP addresses, let's start configuring high availability on our first device. Now I come to the first device. When we come to the first device, there is the setup section on the main page. We will start making our settings by clicking Run Config Sync High Availability Utility in the setup section. Here, there is more than one default gateway warning appears, because we have a default route for both IP version 6 and IP version 4. Let's continue by clicking Next. When we set up our first device before, we made the synchronization settings. Now let's continue by checking again. There are network and serial cable options in the high availability failover method option here. If you are using physical device, you can choose serial cable here. If you are going to failover over the network, you can choose network or network and serial cable. Since we are using virtual devices at the moment, it is not possible to do it with serial cable, so we choose network here. I say next. Here you can see the IP addresses on our internal interface. We set these IP addresses when we installed our device. Our self IP address is 101, our floating IP address is 172.16.0.222. I say next. Here you can see our high availability IP address, at our high availability address 10.1.0.1. We write our subnet mask. We continue by selecting our interface as 1.3 untagged. Here we need to enter the NTP address. The timing needs to be kept when we synchronize in high availability. Therefore, do not forget to write the NTP address here. I say next. Let's write our DNS address. I say next. It asks on which interface we will do the synchronization. Here we choose high availability interface. I say next. Here we have a failover unicast configuration. Here we need to have a high availability interface and a management interface. If these interfaces are not here, you can add them here by saying add. Here I continue by saying next. Here we choose our high availability interface in mirroring configuration and click next. Now we have completed our configuration, we will do the standard pair configuration here on the second device. Let's finish the process by clicking finish. We have finished our configuration on our first device, now let's move on to the second device. When we come to the second device, let's click on Run Config Sync High Availability Utility on the main page. Let's say next. Here I leave the failover method as a network. I say next. Here I am writing the floating IP address as 172.16.0.222. It should be the same on both devices. I leave it in allow default. I set other settings when we set up. Click next to continue. Our high availability address will be 10.1.0.2. We choose our interface as 1.3 untagged and click add. Let's say next. We will also set the external floating IP address under the network tab. Let's enter the NTP address here, 88.199.214.98. Let's write our DNS address. Let's say next. I choose high availability interface for config sync. I say next. Here I click next without making any changes. Here, I choose our mirroring interface as high availability. I say next. Here we will enter the information of our first device by clicking next in the standard pair configuration. I say next. In the discover configuration section, click next and enter the information of our first device. Here, let's write the IP address of our first device. If you want, write the address of management. If you want, write the address of high availability. I will provide the connection with the high availability IP address. We write the username and password on our first device. I click on retrieve device information. The information of our first device has arrived. Let's match the device certificate here. Here, let's give the failover group a name. I'm writing failover sync group. I say add device. Now you can see that the synchronization is pending here. We will adjust the synchronization settings in our next lesson. Now, under the network tab, let's go to self IP and set the floating IP address on the external side. I click create. I'm writing 192.168.10.222 on your name. Our address is the same as our name. Let's write our subnet mask. Let's choose external here. In the port lockdown section, I choose the default. Here, too, I choose traffic group 1 floating. I say finish. Here you can see the IP addresses of our interfaces. You can see our internal self IP address, internal floating IP address, external self IP address, external flashing IP address, IP version 6 floating address and IP version 6 self IP address. In default route, we have default route settings for IP version 6 and IP version 4. Now that we have completed our configurations, I come to the main page. Let's come to your first device. Since we do not synchronize our settings at the moment, we display our status as change pending in the status section. In this lesson, we have configured high availability. In our next lesson, we will set the synchronization settings. See you in our next lesson.